What's up? Gonna tweet about it. There we go. Let's see here. Pull up the little chat window. Looks like it's working. Now it says offline. Configuration quality is excellent. This doesn't make any sense. Well, that's happening. There we go. Let's pop up this chat. Welcome to the chat room. Someone just tweeted the number 2015 to me. I don't even know what that means. All right. Let's click Twitter. Oh, I'm going to turn off my notifications. This is all going really well. All right. This is a lazy stream where I am slouching and all of the technological advancements of the last stream where I had a separate keyboard so you didn't hear all the keyboard pounding. All of that's gone. I am lounging. And I'm probably going to be bad at writing. So we were doing a meandering conversation between Sarah and Andreas. And we want San Andreas. Yes. Yes, Paul. That's what's happening. We want Andreas to seem cool. We're differentiating the characters in some ways, and we're like giving them something to do, talk to each other. But I feel like Andreas is coming across kind of cold and boring, kind of a big lame-o wanting to do homework. It's not cool. So let's see. This is an old trick where you leave off in the middle of a sentence so that you got like some momentum going. Yeah, Andreas is a girl. Even though she has a guy's name, and maybe I'll fix that someday, but I picked the name and I didn't know if it was a guy or a girl's name. I just liked it. It sounded like space things to me. But yeah, drugs. Well, they already smoked a cigarette, right? She's super rebellious. She's really marginally rebellious. I think that's the thing. She is trying to pick her battles and be rebellious in this kind of really small, safe way. But she still, I mean, I think she'd want to go to like college on Earth, but I don't think there's a way for her to do that. I mean, she could get like accepted by Earth College and then like study remotely. That sounds boring. She'd have to like stick around town, live with their parents or something. That is cool. I guess Andreas can just respond to Sarah. So which world? Oh, you know what I mean. Stop talking to me, people. Well, I don't even know why Sarah says this. Changing the world. This whole conversation has never been going well for me. let's start at the start of this conversation and see. Sarah felt sufficiently bored enough to do homework. She pulled out her tablet, Sarah pouted. You always have homework, says Sarah. A symptom of education. It's kind of, I don't know. You know, if you take the stuff too seriously, people get ideas about you. What kind of ideas? Silly, silly, silly. She may have opened her history app at poker. I mean, the teachers, Mr. Oliver, wants you to learn things, isn't it? Isn't he winning every time you open the app? You know, he's just sitting in a dark room somewhere, cackling every time you log on. This study avoidance tactic by Sarah was novel enough for San Andreas. Oh my gosh, I keep on doing that. For Andreas to look up. This new angle on study avoidance was bizarre enough for Andreas to look. Oh, that's right. I didn't like this version, so I wrote another version. Check on Sarah. I mean, I'm kind of joking. What if I wasn't? Everyone knows I'm mine. Let's go to your source garbage. They don't teach you anything before university. It's just glorified babysitting. Something to do anyway, said Andreas. Wouldn't you rather be doing something important? You mean like 22? No, like changing the world. See, now this conversation is almost kind of useful, at least, because I'm, like, you know, explaining a little bit about what the solar system is like. Well, we're putting words on the page, that's for sure. Don't know if it's worth anything, but I kind of like this. It's kind of fun. I think the word garbage. It's kind of my favorite word. I have to try not to use it all the time. What a rejoinder. Whoa. Think of what Andrew is considering. Because you can say something like, or she like play along. Say yes. Yeah. Here's Tired Dream. That's a lame line. See, if they get school off school like 2:15, 2:30, and then they had track practice until like 4:30, and they came home and they watched music videos, so it's like 5:30 when they're having this conversation, or 5:15 maybe. Probably closer to 5:30. It's dinner time. We don't need that. It's a cool idea, though. this to me? The sun was still. In season. Oh, I must have like learned how the moon actually works. Let's see. So the moon goes around the earth, and the earth goes around the sun. And then they have, what was it? They have like 14 days on the moon. As far as the, oh shoot. I looked this all up at one point. Let's see. It takes. Oh, I guess it takes a whole. Yeah. It's a month-long cycle from new moon to full moon to new moon again. So they have month-long days. And then they have artificial light. So let's say the sun is, so it's not artificial light. Hmm. I haven't played StarCraft in a long time. I really want to play the new one with my buddy Jordan. I think that's the last time. No, that can't be the last time I played StarCraft. No. But yeah, I want to play the Archon, though. This sounds fun. I hate it when I type in this one. Like, I had a timestamp on this file from the last time I actually edited it, but then I accidentally made some changes and then saved it as like a reflex. So I don't have a timestamp on Not a great sentence. The tunnel of flowers and look at that semicolon. Like, it's not even a big deal. It's just dropping semicolons. Like, I know what they're actually for. Like, hate him is a little strong there, Andreas. He's playing like with some kind of like Oculus Rift, basically, but you know, full body tracking and using his house as the terrain somehow. I like this little moment of how Andreas is her brother. Her mom a moisture farmer? I don't know what that is. Oh gosh, you guys need, is that a Star Wars reference? Just calm down, okay? The movie will come out and you can all watch Star Wars and we can talk about Star Wars. There's other sci-fi. It's not the only science fiction that has ever existed. And I apologize if that isn't a Star Wars reference and I bet this is a Star Wars reference. Homework wasn't as fun. Oh, gosh. Okay. All right. You get a pass for making a callback. Good theme you've got going. I like it. Hmm. Oh, this is a good one. This is a good one. That's a good line, Paul. We're really getting the meat of this. We are going on a tour of her room. That's what all you guys signed up for. Oh, I can't use italics, just in dialogue. All good stuff. Whoa, did you guys see that? My CPU was like negative 35,000%. I could hack all of the mainframes with that kind of computer power. That was mean. Scotty got fat. Think that's how you spell naivety? Whoa. How do you spell that word? I remember the last time I can't see the stream drop when I use Spotlight. So there we go. Oh, it's got a little funky thing. Nah. Oh, naivete. Ooh, British people saying, oh, look at them. Naivete. Naivete. Plot so far. Yeah, so we're in chapter one right now. There's two girls sitting in the grass, and they say, Sarah, I picked Andreas. They smoke a cigarette. The sprinkler comes on. Then the next day they go to school, and at track practice that afternoon, they don't really get in trouble. But their coach does have them run some extra laps, but it's not a big deal. Then they go over to Sarah's house and they watch some music videos. And then Andreas wants to do homework, and Sarah tries to argue her out of it. Now Andreas is at home after a long, hard day of being a high school student on the moon. And yeah. And I'm sure you, if you really want to, you know what? I didn't move my last two streams over to YouTube yet, so I'll put them over on YouTube in there. And see, I did some more outlining in some other previous episodes. Something I'm really bad at, and I need to figure out. To be honest, it might not even be that hard to like go back through and fix these. But like, a lot of times when people write dialogue, I mean, there's lots of different styles for it. But you'll be like, well, said Scotty, flipping her hair over her shoulder. Like you like work in little actions, like in the conversation between Sarah and Andreas before, like Andrea or Sarah, I mean Andreas has her tablet that I have her mess with those just a little bit, but like Sarah should be like getting a glass of water or something like that. Like kind of that, I don't know, the Law and Order style where like every time you're talking to somebody they're doing something. But I don't know. When I listen to, I mostly read books by listening to them on audiobooks, and I tune out that part. I'm just listening to the dialogue. I like don't even really hear those little decorations. So maybe they're useful and they are helping set the tone. I just don't think about them. Or maybe they are not that useful and you can just have dialogue, dialogue, dialogue. So I don't know. Check this out. Wait. Okay, Vim has DT period. Delete. So you like you can delete to like if you're at this quote, DT quote. It's pretty cool. Vin is really cool. I mean, this is another thing, like, should, like, said Andreas thoughtfully, or just say, said Andreas, I don't know. You love it, I'm sure. Yeah. Oh, so I did a math class. I knew I did a class somewhere. Quanta? Somebody's named Quanta? See, this is the fun part of writing a novel, is that you can, like, go through the parts of your novel that you haven't read in a long time and think that they're really stupid sounding. So this is not our ending. This chapter is going to end when, basically around when Andreas, chapter ends, oh, put this in caps, chapter ends when Andreas and Scotty are done talking and Andreas goes to bed. So, like, you have basically this evening of them smoking a cigarette, and then chapter one is really all about one day in the life of Andreas. And I'm also was thinking about this today on the train. Oh, see, also sometimes I have no idea what I'm doing with. Oh, I'm like, oh, because calves are on. See, sometimes. Oh my gosh. I'm terrible at them. And then I was thinking it'd be cool if at the end of this chapter I say, that's why I picked Andreas. Like, I don't know if. See, we have the little and big mysteries. Who chose Andreas and why? Medium mystery. Who is Andreas and why would somebody pick her? Medium answer. Cool, self-contained person for whom life is easy and she chooses something more. I want to answer this at the end of chapter one. See? So let's. Okay, I think. We need to, like, delete this swap file somehow. Oh, well, doesn't matter. Okay. Let's make sure we get that. It's called Vim. It's a command line based, like a terminal based text editor for Linux and Mac, and there's a Windows version too. Okay. This is byword over here, which is how I've traditionally done my writing. But getting into the Vim, I use Vim for coding, and I'm trying to learn how to do it for prose too. Okay. I like leaving myself a little bit something to do to finish off this chapter. be a little less tired maybe the next time I stream. And then we can go into chapter 2. It's not even going to be a big deal. So thank you for watching and chatting with me. Oh my gosh. Well, this lazy stream, it's not going to be like this all the time. It's not always going to be lazy stream. But this is fun for me. All right.